Okay, students, we continue some more questions under partial fractions method. So this is perhaps class number 19. Still we work problems concerned to partial fractions of integration. Next problem, evaluate. Integration. X divided by 1 minus x into x square plus 1. So first step, begin from I as usual, that is understood. Let I equal to given integration problem, call 1. And we need to apply partial fractions. So using partial fractions, let us take the integrand part. Integrand part is x divided by 1 minus x into x square plus 1. Observe, this is linear factor, this is unfactorizable quadratic factor, refer the table of rows of partial fractions. From that, what we find is that a divided by 1 minus x plus, next you cannot write b divided by, because this is unfactorizable quadratic factor. If it were factorizable, then you can write b divided by plus c divided by, but this is unfactorizable and quadratic factor. So way of writing partial fraction is bx plus c divided by x square plus 1. Come equation 2. What is the next step? Taking LCM in right hand side. Left hand side, x divided by 1 minus x into x square plus 1. Right hand side, LCM, 1 minus x into x square plus 1. X plus c into 1 minus x. Obviously, both sides' denominator factors will cancel out. Left out, x equals to a into x square plus 1 plus bx plus c into 1 minus x. So this is equation 3. We have linear factor. What is that? 1 minus x. So we can put easily x equal to 1. Put x equal to 1 in equation 3. Left side 1. Right side a into 1 plus 1. But the next term will be 0 because of 1 minus 1 is 0 plus 0. So 1 equal to 2a. Or a equals to 1 by 2. Now we compare better coefficient of x square. Compare coefficient of x square in equation 3. square in equation 3, left side 0, right side a. Here x into a, x into minus x square. Keep that in mind. So minus x square along with b. Hence now coefficient will be minus b. Implies b equal to a, but a value is found as 1 by 2. B also becomes 1 by 2. Next, either compare constants equally same as, put x equal to 0 in equation 3, both are same at 1 end. Put x equal to 0 in equation 3. 0 equals to a into 0 plus 1 plus b into 0, 0 plus c into 1 minus 0. That is 0 equals to a plus c. Hence c equal to how much? Minus a. That means c equal to minus 1 by 2. Because a is found as plus 1 by 2. That's why c becomes minus 1 by 2. Now write from 2 using in 1. From 2 using in 1. That word is right. From 2 using in 1. Or you can say from 2 1 changes to I equals to integration a by 1 minus x plus bx plus c by x square plus 1. So let us substitute values of ABC. On putting values of ABC, A is found as 1 by 2 divided by 1 minus x. B is also found as 1 by 2 into x. Whereas C value is found as minus 1 by 2. And all this is divided by x square plus 1. Before we split terms and integrations 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2, hence 1 by 2 can be taken as common into integration 1 by 1 minus x plus x minus 1 divided by x square plus 1. In this second term, we separate the terms, we split the terms, x by x square plus 1, minus 1 by x square plus 1 like that. Hence, 1 by 2 into integration, 1 by 1 minus x, x by x square plus 1, minus 1 divided by x square plus 1. So now we can split into how many integrations? 3 integrations. And at the same time, here is an adjustment because the differentiation of x square plus 1 is found to be 2x. In the second term, we multiply and divide by 2. 1 by 2, bracket, first term, integration of 1 by 1 minus x. In the second, let's multiply and divide by 2 to make a formula. F dash x by f of x, 2x divided by x square plus 1 minus 1 divided by x square plus 1 dx. replied, concerned the answer of integrations. Integration of 1 by 1 minus x is no doubt to log of 1 minus x. But here, be correct and be attentive, be careful, because x is having a coefficient. What is coefficient of x? Minus 1. Actually, it has to divide. So, minus 1 divide equally same as multiply. This is key step. If it were x minus 1, no question of extra minus n, because in this case x coefficient is 1. Here x coefficient is minus 1, you must take care of that. Plus 1 by 2. This integration is in the form of integration of f dash x by f of x, log of f of x means log of x square plus 1. And whereas here, again a formula, integration of 1 by 1 plus x square is tan inverse of x plus. Next question, quite analogous, you put the efforts yourself in form, evaluate. Integration dx plus pi divided by x cube minus x square minus x plus 1 dx. I give some steps, hints. Then we can continue. Actually, denominator is cubic expression. So for cubic expression, we can't impose partial fractions. We try to get the factors of denominator. Let's consider denominator. That is x cube minus x square minus x plus 1. In these two terms, x square common, left is x minus 1, in the remaining two terms, minus 1 is common, left is x minus 1. Once again, common x minus 1, that means it is x minus 1 into x square minus 1. But x square minus 1 can be factorizable, that is x minus 1. Into x square minus 1 means x minus 1 into x plus 1. That becomes x minus 1 whole square into x plus 1. So now our problem I becomes as. Therefore now I equals to integration 3x plus 5 divided by x plus 1 into x minus 1 whole square. And I hope that remaining steps you will continue yourself, because already it is solved problem. The earlier hours is same time we have solved. I hope you will solve it. Remaining steps, from this apply partial fractions. How to apply? A divided by x plus 1, b divided by x minus 1, plus c divided by x minus 1 whole square, then continue, get the values of a, b, c, and lastly, get the answer of integration. I hope you people solve yourself without fail, because in the same time, already we solved similar 2-3 questions in the earlier class. That's why I am leaving for your sight. Another one, very much similar, that also will be kept as limits left as homework. Evaluate. Integration x square plus x plus 1 divided by x cube plus x square plus x plus 1 dx. Again, I give the hint of this problem. take denominator. Consider denominator that is x cubed plus x squared plus x plus 1. In the first two terms, common is x squared, left is x plus 1. In the next two terms, common is 1, left is x plus 1. Again common, x plus 1, that makes x plus 1 into x squared plus 1. But in the last problem, this were factorizable because x square minus 1 means x square minus 1 square, a square minus b square, a plus b to a minus b. But this is unfactorizable, and unfactorizable quadratic expression. Keeping that in mind, now our problem I becomes as integration x square plus x plus 1 divided by x plus 1 into x square plus 1. Then you apply partial fractions, you take this separately, a divided by x plus 1 plus bx plus c divided by x square plus 1, remaining like in the previous problems. I hope you will continue that. These two left as your assignment in home. We continue further problems. Under partial fractions, find or evaluate. Find or evaluate integration of cos x dx divided by 1 minus sin x multiplied by 2 minus sin x. First step, start from I. Let I equal to given problem column 1 and wait for a while. I will wait for a while here. Directly you can't apply partial fractions because we don't have algebraic factors at all. But we can convert it into algebraic factor type, and there is a connection between sin x and cos x. What is cos x? Cos x is differentiation of sin x. So we shall put z equal to sin x. Substitute z equal to sin x, compulsorily differentiate, which implies dz by dx equal to cos x, or only dz equal to cos x into dx. Now write from 2 and 3, 1 changes to as I equal to integration dz divided by 1 minus z into 2 minus z. But write 2 and z properly. Now for this expression we can apply partial fractions because these two are linear factors. Now write by partial fractions we have. By partial fraction consider 1 divided by 1 minus z into 2 minus z. That is written as a divided by 1 minus z plus b divided by 2 minus z. Taking LCM in right hand side. On taking LCM in right hand side, after LCM, denominator factors will cancel out. Hence, 1 equals to a into 2 minus z plus b into 1 minus z. We call equation 5 and 6. First, what value of z? 1. put z equal to 1 implies 1 equals to a into 2 minus 1 but b into 0. So 1 equals to a or a equals to 1. Next, what value of z? 2. Put z equal to 2 in equation 6. So now 1 equals to a into 0 plus b into 1 minus 2. That is 1 equals to minus b. Nothing but b equal to how much? Minus 1. Now say the word that from 5. Changes to means for 1 by 1 minus z and 2 minus z we can write a by 1 minus z plus b by 2 minus z. So write from 5 using in 4. I becomes integration a by 1 minus z plus b by 2 minus z. Now replace values of a and b. A value is 1, b value is minus 1. That is equal to integration 1 divided by 1 minus z minus 1 divided by 2 minus z. We split the integrations. First one, integration of 1 by 1 minus z and dz minus integration of 1 by 2 minus z and dz. But integration of 1 by 1 minus z is log of 1 minus z. Not only log of 1 minus z, the additional minus sign. Minus 1. Similar, integration of 1 by 2 minus z is log of 2 minus z. Not only log of 2 minus z, extra z coefficient is minus, and minus minus will become plus, plus constant c. Or it is just like log m minus log n, log of m by n formula can be used. That means it is log of 2 minus z by 1 minus z plus c. But now write back z value. What is z value? Sin x. Where you write without fail, where z equal to sin x. Find or evaluate. Find integration of 2x dx divided by x square plus 1 into x square plus 4. Take I equal to problem. And 1 minute you observe this problem, mechanism of solving. There are two ways. One way, directly take this expression, apply partial fractions, means 2x divided by x square plus 1 and x square plus 4, both are unfactorizable quadratic factors. So we have tried ax plus b by x square plus 1 plus cx plus d by x square plus 4. Then we have to get values of a, b, c, d. That's one method. But one should not forget there is a presence of x. In fact, here 2x. And more importantly, what is 2x? Differentiation of x square. So this problem can be made very easier by taking substitution for x square equals to t. Put t equal to x square. That will be easier one more. If we don't have x, no other way, only one way. Ax plus b by x square plus 1 plus cx plus d by x square plus 4, that method would have been applied. Because of 2x, take that advantage. After differentiation, dt by dx equal to 2x implies that only dt equal to 2x into dx. Now write from 2 and 3, 1 changes to 2. Or from 2 and 3 using in 1. From 2 and 3 using in 1, I equal to integration dt divided by t plus 1 into t plus 4. Let's apply partial fractions. Next slide. By partial fractions we have, by partial fractions we have, take integrand part. What is integrand part? 1 divided by t plus 1 into t plus 4. Consider 1 by t plus 1 into t plus 4. Both are linear factors. So we should write a divided by t plus 1 plus b divided by t plus 4. Say equation 5. What is the next step? Taking LCM in right hand side. Taking LCM in right hand side. On taking LCM in right hand side, after LCM, both side denominator factors will cancel. That's an obvious step. So we get 1 equals to a into t plus 4 plus b into t plus 1. Now we have to put t equal to minus 1, then t equal to minus 4, because the factors are t plus 1 and t plus 4. Put t equal to minus 1 in equation 6. That is 1 equals to a into minus 1 plus 4, b into minus 1 plus 1. Next factor is t plus 4, hence put t equal to minus 4. Put t equal to minus 4 in equation 6. Therefore, 1 equals to a into 0, b into minus 3. Because minus 4 plus 1 become minus 3, hence 1 equal to minus 3b or b equal to minus 1y. I becomes integration, and all this is resolved by partial fractions a by plus b by, a by plus b by, a by t plus 1 plus b by t plus 4. Replace values of a and b, a 1 by 3, b minus 1 by 3. That is integration 1 by 3 divided by t plus 1 minus 1 by 3 divided by t plus 4. Finally, 1 by t. Integration of 1 by t plus 1 is log of t plus 1. Similarly, integration of 1 by t plus 4 is log of t plus 4 plus constant c. Further, we can use log theorem. It is just like log m minus log n, log of m divided by n. So finally, I becomes 1 by 3 log of, modulus can be inserted, t plus 1 divided by t plus 4 plus, but you must replace back value of t, more importantly. What is t value? X square, where t equals to x square. But you replace it without fail in these places. So answer, what it become? X square plus 1 divided by x square plus 4. I hope that work will do it. Next one, similar to the last problem type, you put the efforts yourself, evaluate integration e raised to x plus 2 into e raised to x dx divided by e raised to x minus 1 into e raised to x plus 4. And in this problem, easily you can expect a substitution. I give the hint that put t equal to e power x, dt equal to how much? E power x into dx. So now our problem, I becomes as, this is t plus 2, remaining is dt divided by t minus 1 into t plus 4 dt. Next step will be by partial fractions. Let me continue. Apply partial fractions a by t minus 1 plus b by t plus 4. Put t equal to 1, put t equal to minus 4. Get values of a and b. Lastly, your answers are in the form of log, and replace back value of t d value is e power x. Next question, still on the partial fractions. I don't know number of problems. You please maintain, maybe 15, 16, I don't know that exactly. But you maintain the number of problems. Next problem. Find or evaluate integration 1 divided by x into x to the power of n plus 1 dx. Take I. Let I equal to given integration problem column 1. Right now we can't apply partial fractions because we don't know exactly value of n. If it were n value 1 linear factor, we can apply partial fractions. N value is 2, it's a quadratic factor, we can apply partial fractions. But if n is 3, 4, 5, we can't apply partial fractions. So we shall take some useful steps like this. What I do is that inside integration, we multiply and divide by x to the power of n minus 1. Multiplying and dividing by x to the power of n minus 1, that is inside integration. In the integration, multiplying, dividing by x to the power of n minus 1. I becomes integration. X to the power n minus 1 dx divided by x into x to the power n minus 1 into x to the power n plus 1, or I equals to integration x to the power of n minus 1 dx divided by. Here x power n minus 1 into x to the power of x, 1, 1 minus 1, 0 means x power n into x power n plus 1. Now easily we can expect that substitution. Put x power n equal to t. Put t equal to x power n. Then compulsorily differentiate. On differentiation, dt by dx equals to n into x power n minus 1. But we have only x power n minus 1. That means we don't want n. N will be divided to left side. So which implies dt divided by n equals to x power n minus 1 into dx. Now say the word that from 3 and 4 using in 2, or from 3 and 4 2 changes to I equals to integration. X power n minus 1 dx can be written as dt divided by n by t into t plus 1. But 1 by n is constant, we can keep outside the integration. 1 by n into integration 1 divided by t into t plus 1. Now for this expression we can apply partial fractions. By partial fractions. By partial fractions. You take this integrand part. Integrand part is 1 by t into t plus 1. And how many factors are there? Two factors. You must take two constants, a divided by t plus b divided by t plus 1. Take LCM in the right hand side. Next up, taking LCM in the right hand side. After LCM, always both sides denominated terms will cancel it. But after LCM, not before LCM. So after LCM, these two terms will cancel out. Left is 1 equals to A into T plus 1 plus B into T. Carlson. Which factor is there? T. Means T minus 0. Put T equal to 0. Put T equal to 0 in 7. 1 equals to A into 0 plus 1 plus B into 0 is 0. All that makes A equal to 1. Next, which factor is there? T plus 1. What it suggests? Put T equal to minus 1. Next, put T equal to minus 1 in equation 7. So now 1 equals to A into 0 plus B into minus 1. That is 1 equals to minus B, therefore B equal to minus 1. Now write from 6 using in 5, or from 6 5 changes. From 6 using in 5 now. But that word you write, from 6 using in 5, I becomes 1 by m into integration, and all this is equality defined by a by t plus b by t plus 1, a by t plus b by t plus 1. Replace values of a and b correctly. A 1, b minus 1. 1 divided by m integration 1 by t minus 1 by t plus 1. Let's make how many integrations? 2 integrations. 1 by m. First one, integration of 1 by t dt minus integration of 1 by t plus 1 dt. Final, 1 by n, integration of 1 by t log t, integration of 1 by t plus 1 log of t plus 1 plus constant. This is in the form of log p minus log q. So from log theorems, log p minus log q is given by log p divided by q. So it is in the form of log p minus log q, log of p divided by q, that is 1 by n into log of t divided by t plus 1 plus, but replace back value of t, how much t value? X power n. Finally, our problem answer becomes as, with writing back t value is x power n. So finally, I means our problem, 1 by x into x power n plus 1 dx equals to 1 by n into log modulus of t means x power n divided by x power n plus 1 plus c. So remember this problem answer for shortcut method. Just like standard result, keep this answer in memory without pain. This will help to save time in MCQ problem. Single question, you work out, find or evaluate integration 1 by x into x power 7 plus 1. Answer can be said. What is answer? N means 7, 1 by 7, log of x power 7 by x power 7 plus 1. But that is only for MCQ. For theory, work out with steps like in the previous problem. And here, you need to multiply and divide. Use a hint, multiply dividing by how much of x power 6. So that here x power 6 by x power 7 into x power 7 plus 1, after that put t equal to x power 7. Remaining steps like in the last problem, you continue. I hope you continue like in the last problem for this case. Please, you solve this problem yourself in home, exactly similar to last problem. Instead of n, I given 7. Method remains same. We have one standard result or shortcut method or time saving result, standard result. As good as a time saving result. Based on this problem, integration dx by x in x to the power n plus k is always equal to 1 divided by n into k, 1 by n k into log of modulus of x power n divided by x power n plus k. Remember it, it's a time saving result, but use only for MCQ examination. For theory exam, like in the last problem, you have to continue. For example, how this can be used to save time. For example, integration of 1 by x into x power 8 plus 3 dx equals to. Actual method is that multiply and divide by x power 7. But because of this formula available, use this. Here n. What is n? 8, k, 3, answer. 1 by 8 into 3 means 1 by 24, because 8 into 3 is 24, into log of x power 8 divided by x power 8 plus 3 plus constant. But if this is given in theory for 3 or 5 marks, you cannot use this, you will get less marks. your method is that multiply divided by x power 7. Only for MCQ exam, this can be taken as shortcut method. Another example, integration 1 divided by x into x power 4 minus 5. Compare n, what is n? 4. More importantly, k, what is k? Minus 5. So 1 by 4 into minus 5 into log x power 4 by x power 4 minus 5. And you can write 4 into minus 5 as minus 20. Minus 1 by 20 log of x power 4 by x power 4 minus 5 plus c is the final answer. Next one, find or evaluate. Evaluate integration 3x minus 1 divided by x minus 2 whole cube. Actually, in the book, NCERT book, this kind of problem given under partial fractions method, but we can solve without using partial fractions also. We can apply partial fraction, no wrong. How to write a by x minus 2 plus b by x minus 2 whole square plus c by x minus 2 whole cube can be written. But we can solve without using partial fractions also like this. First step, take a. Next step, integration 3. Try to get the factor x minus 2 in numerator. So with x, subtract 2, add 2. And separately minus 1 divided by x minus 2 whole cube. I told that this problem I am solving without partial fractions method. Open the bracket, 3 into x minus 2. Plus 3 into 2 will be 6. That is integration 3 into x minus 2 plus 6. 3 into x minus 2 plus 6 minus 1 divided by x minus 2 whole cube. What is 6 minus 1? 5. That is integration 3 into x minus 2 plus 5 divided by x minus 2 whole cube. Now we separating terms, splitting terms by LCM rule, a by c plus b by c. Then total integration 3 into x minus 2 divided by x minus 2 whole cube. Another term will be 5 divided by x minus 2 whole cube. Here x minus 2 factor cancels, 3 outside into integration of 1 by x minus 2 cube whole square plus 5 outside into integration of 1 by x minus 2 whole cube. Now you can shift at numerator, 3 into integration of x minus 2 whole to the power of minus 2 plus 5 into integration of x minus 2 to the power of minus 2. Now applying non-integration formula. just like integration of x power n. As long as there is no x coefficient, don't worry. But if there is x coefficient, you have to divide. How much x coefficient? 1. Not even. Don't divide anything. It is just like integration of x power n. X power n plus 1 by n plus 1 means x minus 2 to the power of 4 minus 1 divided by minus 1, because minus 2 plus 1 will become minus 1. Plus 5 into x minus 2 to the power of minus 3 plus 1 is minus 2 divided by minus 2 plus. Lastly, we can write 1 by x minus 2 along with minus 3. Here minus 5 by 2 and into 1 by x minus 2 also. So this completes integration by partial fraction method. The next class will be integration of product of two functions, what it is called by the name integration by parts. So that we shall see in the next class, that is in class number 20. We are going to study integration of product of two functions. My request come order is that please daily practice these problems so that you will feel very easier. When you practice after some long gap, it becomes very complicated. So try to complete that day's work of study on the same day so that you will feel very comfortable. We shall meet next class for integration by parts.